Guys, onto the international scene. R. Kelly's woes appear to be compounding. Yes. Now he has yet again been denied bail. That's sad.
Very, very, very sad.
It's not sad, but okay.
Yes, it is sad.
Is it heavy sadness? Because he's
expected.
Trying.
He's expected. I don't know. Like,
no, but the thing is, R. Kelly is broke now. So the
really?
the
yeah,
the, that lady collected. She paid for his bond bail.
She asked her money back.
Yeah,
you know, and then he stopped paying child support. Like, he's broke, really. And well, he's been denied bail. Now, according to Page Six, R. Kelly had asked to be freed while awaiting trial. Well, his lawyers argued that he doesn't have any money to flee, even if he wanted to. That's why they're like, okay, let's just let him be. Like, give him bail because he can't flee even if he wanted to. However, a Brooklyn federal judge, Ann Donnelly, denied that request on Wednesday, October 2nd. According to her, Kelly is accused of committing crimes involving, in her words, very young girls. His finances are murky, to say the least. And the proposed home detention certainly wouldn't do nothing to deter him from intimidating witnesses, even though R. Kelly wasn't in court for the sitting. His lawyers were unable to convince the judge to grant him bail. A new date, May 18, 2020, has been set for trial, and the judge said the proceeding is expected to last about 3 weeks.
Whoa.
So until 2020, R. Kelly's going to be in jail.
I'm even tired. Like, what's up with R. Kelly's case? How long is he going to be dragged for the... Okay,
no,
I'm not saying
that.
No,
it will be
saying,
the first.
No, I'm not saying that it's wrong for them to drag him, but then I think he should just take his punishment and rest.
Okay, for what? 2020 is just like 2 months away.
Still.
So, but
yeah,
then,
but
now
he has to wait till about
May,
which is about
exactly.
7 months.
But the thing is, like, but from the judge's judgment, they said they can't grant him bail because he's been accused of crime. So somehow they feel like
there could be an atom
of truth
you
in
can,
the allegations.
The thing is, I think they're trying to punish him because, you know, at the beginning of the trials and everything, he had this pride and ego because he's R. Kelly, so
yes,
away with anything.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're trying to punish him because on a normal basis, someone as big as R. Kelly, he will be granted bail and put on house arrest.
I remember that there was a time when the first time when this whole issue came out, when people were doing documentaries, when there was a documentary about him. The next thing you know, R. Kelly went to celebrate his birthday at the club.
Exactly.
Like, so nothing
happened.
Ain't nothing
wrong
with me.
One of the reasons why you're right that they might want to punish him. But then again, the judges are saying his finances are murky. So there's no way he's going to get
bail. It being murky means so you cannot do anything.
There's no way of getting bail.
So I don't know why they're keeping him in prison. So like I said,
it means he can't get bail.
So he should actually rest the case.
If R. Kelly wants bail, there are people that can bail him out.
Nobody right now. Everybody's leaving their head.
Trust me, nobody wants to get involved, but when there is an opening for him to get bail, trust me, the money would come out.
Even if he gets bail, I feel it's even going to be dangerous for him because
the streets are not house arrest. It's simple. Put him on house arrest.
You remember when he was in solitary? He cried out he wanted to come out of solitary because he was running mad.
Yes.
Now, I feel like no one right now, R. Kelly is the jungle, whether we like it or not. His family has left him. The only two people with him right now are his girlfriends. He's alleged.
In the prison, he can actually, if he gets so, you know, the whole thing gets to his head, he can actually commit suicide. So
yes.
Let's hope that doesn't happen.
But then what I meant by the streets are not safe, even if he's under house arrest, people have this vendetta against him already. Mm-hmm.
No,
yes.
He's going to have security 24/7. That one I know for sure.
Wow.
As long as for a good person.
What's the difference? It's still prison in your house.
It's better that it's your house. You're free to do whatever. You can walk around. He's got a mansion, so he can go anywhere. But the thing is, he can't leave the premises. So.
But then he's going to go back to the same house with the ladies that are refusing to leave the house, Azrielle and
Jocelyn. No, they can actually put him under the government, whatever.
One room, one room around.